Welcome back to my stand-up channel. Laughing and crying, 8 out of 10 cats host Jimmy Carr leads tributes to panelist Sean Locke as he dies aged 58 after quietly wrestling with cancer. The British comedy world today paid tribute to the truly unique voice of Sean Locke after the much-loved 8 out of 10 cats star died of cancer aged 58 surrounded by his family at home. The comedian, known for his surreal content and deadpan style, was best known as a team captain on Jimmy Carr's popular Channel 4 comedy panel show and its spin-off 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown. Carr led the tributes today, saying it was brutal news, and that he was laughing and crying while watching clips of Locke today, while his friend Lee Mack, who called him a true original both in comedy and life. Father of three, Locke, who had two daughters and one son with his wife Anushka, appeared on Have I Got News For You, Chi, and They Think It's All Over, and also wrote and starred in the popular BBC sitcom 15 Stories High. John Richardson, Locke's fellow captain on 8 out of 10 Cats, praised his incredible comic brawn. Susie Dent from the Countdown version described him as an exceptional man. Ricky Gervais said he was one of the funniest, most influential comedians of a generation. And Alan Davies said Locke was funny on stage, hilarious off. Locke's agent labeled the Woking-born star as one of Britain's finest comedians, saying his boundless creativity, lightning wit and the absurdist brilliance of his work marked him out as a unique voice in British comedy. It is not known what form of a cancer Locke had battled, but he previously made a full recovery from skin cancer, which he blamed on overexposure to the sun while working on building sites before he became a comedian. He previously credited a one-night stand in the 1990s with saving his life, after the woman he was with spotted a black and misshapen patch of skin on his back, which he had removed in hospital, and it was diagnosed as cancer. A statement from his agent Off the Curb Productions said, "It is with great sadness that we have to announce the death of Sean Locke. He died at home from cancer, surrounded by his family. Sean was one of Britain's finest comedians. His boundless creativity, lightning wit and the absurdist brilliance of his work marked him out as a unique voice in British comedy. Sean was also a cherished husband and father to three children. Sean will be sorely missed by all that knew him. We kindly request that the privacy of his family and children is respected at this difficult time." Carr, who worked with Sean Locke on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, said on Twitter, "Brutal news about Sean Locke today. I loved him. I'm watching clips of him right now, laughing and crying. I'll miss him so much." Comedian Mack, who was a close friend, paid tribute saying, "I've known this day was coming for some time, but it's no less heartbreaking. A true original both in comedy and life. I will miss him so much." And his 8 out of 10 Cats colleague John Richardson said, "I idolized Sean as a comic long before I became a comedian myself, and 10 years working alongside him didn't diminish that in the least. An incredible comic brain and a truly unique voice. I'm devastated for his family today and sad for comedy that we have lost one of the very best. Undisputed, undefeated, carrot in a box champion. I will miss him." Susie Dent, who worked alongside Locke on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown from Dictionary Corner, has also paid tribute to him. She wrote on Twitter, "I wish I had the words to describe the exceptional man that was Sean Locke. But today I don't, and I think he might have liked it that way." And Ricky Gervais said, "Such sad news. RIP. The great Sean Locke. One of the funniest, most influential comedians of a generation. A lovely man." Comedian Alan Davies also paid tribute to hilarious Locke, writing on Twitter, "Sad news about Sean Locke. Funny on stage, hilarious off. We met in 1988, right at the start of our stand-up careers. I hadn't seen him in recent years as he quietly wrestled with illness, but I feel very sad today for Anushka and their children. RIP, Locke." Pointless host Richard Osman, who worked with Sean Locke as a producer on panel show 8 out of 10 Cats, wrote on Twitter. Over 15 years producing 8 out of 10 Cats, Sean Locke made me laugh so much and so often. A unique and brilliant comic voice. Love to his family and his many friends. Eddie Izzard also paid tribute to Locke, saying, "So sorry to hear this. Farewell, Sean. You brought a wonderful comedic talent to the world and you will be missed." Gary Lanker added, "Awful news. Such a funny man." And comedian Jason Manford paid tribute to Locke, saying that he had texted the comedian a few weeks prior to his death. He wrote on Twitter, "I'm absolutely gutted about this. So heartbroken for his wife and children. One of the funniest men I've ever worked with, and I used to adore occasionally making him laugh on my first proper telly job, 8 out of 10 Cats. I texted him a couple of weeks ago and I'm now so glad I did. If you've a friend who you've not spoken to for a while, drop them a message and check in. It could be the last time." And comedian David Baddiel said, "Devastated to hear about Sean Locke. He toured with Newman and Baddiel on our last show together. One of the funniest men I ever knew." Presenter Gabby Logan, who has appeared alongside Sean Locke on 8 out of 10 Cats, paid tribute to the comedian, who could make your cheeks ache from laughing. She tweeted, "Just awful to hear the news about Sean Locke. I was lucky enough to watch his genius comedy up close when appearing on 8 out of 10 Cats a good few times." She added, "Love and light to all of his family and friends." Comedian Bill Bailey paid tribute, saying, "It's heartbreaking to lose my dearest friend Sean Locke. He was a true original, a wonderful comic. All my thoughts are with his family." Comedian Ross Noble said, "With the passing of Sean Locke, we have lost the best of the best. He made me laugh like few others do. A massive talent who made stand-up look effortless and approached his illness in the same no-nonsense way he approached life. A great loss." And Tim Vine tweeted, "Very sad to hear about Sean Locke. One of my absolute favorite comics. Always made me laugh. RIP, Sean." Meanwhile, a Channel 4 spokesman said, "Incredibly sad to learn of the loss of one of our greatest comedians, Sean Locke." The channel wrote on Twitter, "A much-loved part of the C4 family, he's played a huge role on the channel for over 2 decades, and we'll miss him. Our thoughts are with his family and friends." And a tweet from Quizshow Chi said, "We are deeply saddened to hear of Sean Locke's passing. Sean was a Chi regular right from the first series, and helped to shape the show with his fantastically sharp wit and anarchic good humor. Our thoughts are with his friends and family." Born in Woking, Surrey, the comedy star and Chelsea FC fan left school in the early 1980s and began working on building sites, but developed skin cancer, which he blamed on overexposure to the sun. He made a full recovery and focused on a career in comedy. One of his first professional TV appearances was in 1993. Starring alongside Rob Newman and David Baddiel on their signature TV show Newman and Baddiel in Pieces. Locke made history when he became the first comedian to perform at the 12,000 capacity Wembley Arena in 1993, as the support act for Baddiel and Newman. He script edited the 1998 BBC Two series, Is It Bill Bailey?, and had his own show on BBC Radio 4 called 15 Minutes of Misery, which was later expanded into TV series 15 Stories High. The show was set in a tower block and centered on a pessimistic character called Vince, played by Locke, and his flatmate Errol, played by Benedict Wong. In 2005, Locke became a regular team captain on the panel show 8 out of 10 Cats, a role he held for 18 series. Between 2006 and 2007, he hosted Channel 4 series, TV Heaven, Telly Hell, in which he invited celebrities to share their own selection of TV's triumphs and tragedies. Guests on the show included Alan Davies, Johnny Vaughn, David Mitchell, Bill Bailey, Johnny Vegas, and Nick Hancock. Speaking at the time, Locke said, I think one of my all-time favorite shows is Catchphrase with Roy Walker. I loved it. I used to like Roy's restraint, because for a comedian, the opportunity to take the mick out of some of the ridiculous answers could have been too hard to resist. Locke also appeared on panel shows including Have I Got News For You, Chi, and They Think It's All Over. In 2000 he won the Gong for the Best Live Stand-Up at the British Comedy Awards. Speaking about his early life and cancer diagnosis to the Daily Mail in 2010, Locke said, I was 18 and had taken a levels in Woking where I grew up. But I didn't want to go to university so left sixth form college. My father was in the building industry and he found me a job stripping concrete panels off buildings. It was dangerous work on high scaffolds, sometimes 12 hours a day, Monday to Friday. And often weekends too. Over the next 7 years he worked on building sites and gave little consideration to what he was wearing, or any possible sun damage to his skin. He said, I liked the work and the wages minus £340 a week, which, in 1981, was a lot of money. You could hardly ask a big Irish foreman, please could you rub some amber solaire on my back? And we didn't wear hats, either. None of us took any notice of the fact that we were going red. Actually, I never seemed to suffer from sunburn too much, but some of the guys had very pale Irish skin and were so red they must have been in agony. But they would never admit it. Probably because they didn't want to be thought of as soft. Locke also went on holidays abroad, traveling in Europe and working on a kibbutz in Israel. He told the Mail, there were sunscreen products around but nobody really took any notice of factors. I'm not even sure that there were factors on the bottles back then. We just rubbed some kind of oil into our skin and fried. In the late 1980s Locke then started to visit comedy clubs and then began going on stage for open mic evenings. He told the Mail, I'd never been the class clown and comedy was not a fulfillment of a dream. But it worked for me and I seemed to go down well. Then in 1990, he won the British Comedy Award for Best Live Comic. With performances following at London's Royal Albert Hall and Apollo Theatre, and the Oxford Playhouse. Locke said, I was in my late 20s and had been in a long-term relationship which had come to its conclusion, so I was single. But the fact is, I was with a girl called Tina one night and if I hadn't been, well, I'd be dead now, because she noticed something about me that I hadn't. She said there was something weird on my back. I asked her what it looked like and she said it was a patch of skin which was black, misshapen, with a crusty texture and about the size of a 10p piece. I had no idea how long it had been there. It didn't hurt or itch, so there was nothing that would have drawn my attention to it. And being in the small of my back, it was not something you could easily see while looking in a mirror. Sean's GP in Rotherhithe, Southeast London, was concerned enough to make an appointment for him with a dermatologist at Guy's Hospital the following day. The dermatologist was fantastic, Locke said. He saw me immediately and said, this needs to come out right now. He gave me an injection of local anesthetic and cut it out there and then. I felt no actual pain but there was a strange feeling of something flapping on my back, which must have been skin, as they cut out the melanoma. I was told to come back a fortnight later for the results of a biopsy. I felt no anxiety about this whatsoever. In fact, I almost missed the appointment as my alarm didn't go off and I got to Guy's quite late and rather bleary-eyed. I was young and thought nothing could ever harm me, that I was invincible. The doctor asked me, did anyone tell you what we thought when we first saw your back? I replied no, still not thinking there could be anything seriously wrong. We believed it may be a malignant melanoma, and it is, said the doctor. I can still remember my reaction, or rather, non-reaction. I said something like, right. He says, strange as it may sound, I did not associate the word malignant with cancer. I guess then, in 1990, We didn't read much about such health issues in the way we do today, and cancer was not something people really talked about. In any case, to me, it was something which was associated only with old people. I had no idea what the relevance might be to a healthy guy like me. It took a long time for me to take in how significant this malignant melanoma was. Doctors told Locke that had he not been to see his GP and referred to a specialist promptly, 3 to 4 months down the line, the cancer would almost certainly have spread into his lymphatic system and could well have been incurable. Locke said it took him a long time to realize just how lucky he had been to have been diagnosed and treated so quickly. In the 5 years after my melanoma was removed, I heard of more and more cases, and it wasn't just young people. It was happening to older people, more of whom were retiring abroad to the sun, particularly to Spain. But it was only when a friend of my parents died of lymphatic cancer that the full impact of what could have happened hit me, and I knew how lucky I had been. From then on, I started being very careful. I never go in the sun without a shirt on and always use a moisturizer with an SPF every day on my face. I always wear sunglasses and often a Panama hat, even if I'm just walking in the park, if the sun is hot. He added, I never saw Tina again, but if I happen to bump into her, the first thing I'll tell her is that she saved my life. Source: dailymail.co.uk. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching.